Take a long, long sip. Here comes Taylor Hall. If you haven't enjoyed this power forward's moves tonight, well, here's your last chance to look at him. Hall speeds into the Boston zone. Deeks and scores. Bar down.
What a beautiful finish, because Hudobin was right with him. Hudobin didn't bite on the pump or the fake shot on the forehand, and he made a good move to stay with the move to the backhand. And he's right there. But Hall able to get that leverage off the crossbar and in.
Patrice Bergeron picks up the puck. Really try to beat Schneider to the spot. Schneider way out. Bergeron makes the move across, and Schneider is wise to it.
Schneider is real, real deep on this move. I mean, he's trying to stay as patient as he possibly can. Bergeron's going to come in on that offside and then speed up, attack, trying to get him to move to find an opening. Schneider did a nice job of trying to take away the five hole. Looked like Bergeron trying to slide it back against the green.
Jesper Bratt, a sixth round draft choice, puck in the shooter's position. He tries the deep backhand and doesn't get it on goal.
But then he tried to come back forehand, Jack. He had him if he just stayed on the backhand. That puck's gonna, oh, look how much room he had. He tried that one extra move to pull it back to the forehand and lost possession.
So an opening for Boston's David Pastrnak. Takes the curving route, holds it on his hip, Deeks, and oh! Oh, Corey Schneider's underwear is hanging from the rafters. My goodness, what a deep. That is a great goalie who just got totally faked out.
Well, the puck's in a position to shoot when he gets between the hash marks. And then that move to the backhand is where Schneider says, okay, he didn't take the shot. He's gonna go backhand and try to roof the way Hall did. Nope, back to the forehand again.
Drew Stafford, the serpentine route, speeds up. Deeks backhands it. Hudobin stops him with the leg pad, and a chance for the Bruins to win it.
Hudobin again tracking the puck and being patient, allowing Stafford to come to him even with the change of pace. He's able to get from his left back to his right, and Stafford went back in.
David Krejci against Corey Schneider with the game on the line. Krejci, Deeks, and Schneider closes the five hole. We'll go to extra rounds, one at a time here.
You're kind of hoping it ended right here. Krejci has an opportunity to send you home a winner. Tries to get that five hole to open, but Schneider stayed right with him again. Good stick position too along the ice between those legs.
Hingham zone, Brian Boyle. Saved by Hudobin. Tried to shoot it past him.
Yeah, not much of a threat of the D. He's just going to pull up on his forehand right around the hash marks. He wants to get Hudobin to move just a little bit with that little pump fake. And then as he has to move to reset, Boyle tries to beat him high.
Here's Jake DeBrusk, the rookie, with a chance to give Boston its first win after 60 minutes. And Schneider gets a piece of it.
Not a bad idea to go to the hot hand. Jake DeBrusk with points on the board in the last four. He tries that little pump fake too to get Schneider to move, and then quick forehand high. Just like Hudobin, Schneider gets it.
Pavel Zacha has had a disappointing season. He speeds up and tries to go backhand forehand, but Hudobin gets the stick in the way of the final move.
Well, again, everybody looking for the deke here for the most part. Boyle went for the shot, but Zacha tried to make that move back to the forehand as well.
Ryan Spooner coming off the groin injury, his first game back. He does that 10-2 thing where he opens up both skate blades. It's very deceptive. Will he use it against Schneider? Big curling root. There it is. And he misses over the top. I thought he had his spot open.
So did he. Makes the move that he wants to make, just as you described, prior to him even making it. 10-2 move. Get Schneider off that near post, get him down on the butterfly and go high.
You go number one in the entry draft. People expect you to score here. Nico Hischier, who Tobin gets active and pokes it away and then stares down Hischier. Get my, that schoolyard stuff out of here.
Yeah, more than a stare. I think there was something verbal there, too. Hudobin down on that butterfly, going to extend the stick, or at least the threat of the poke check. What's this, the fourth chance for Boston to win it, or third? Fourth. End it right here.
Krejci, DeBrusk, and Spooner. Here's Solaric, the rangy winger. Saved by Schneider.
Well, similar to Spooner in the sense that he's trying to go high glove. Again, come on the offside, get to the middle with the goaltender moving, quick release.
Seventh round of the shootout. Adam Henrique accelerates, deeks, and goes right past the post.
Lost control. It's the third devil that's actually lost control when they get in tight by the net.
I think Hudobin's in their heads. Seriously. He's a little bit unpredictable.
Come on, you need a win here, boys.
Riley Nash stops and rakes one off the post.
Now, once again, a change of speeds. Riley Nash is going to come with a lot of pace, but he's really going to put the brakes on once he gets to the hash mark. He's got that puck in the shooting area. He's looking for his spot. He gets it. Low stick under the blocker. Unfortunately, all iron.
Will Butcher was voted the best player in college hockey a year ago. Stick handles in, and what a glove save by Hudobin!
Well, Butcher's certainly going to get a shot away. Kind of lost the puck a little bit as he got into that shooting area, but he still put it where he wanted to, and Hudobin gets it with the glove.
Is the sixth time the charm? Danton Heinen has a four-game scoring streak going. Here he has a chance to win it, and Schneider makes a blocker save. It'll go to the ninth round.
Most players like to come on the offside and get to the middle of the ice. It improves your angle, gets your goaltender to move. Everybody's trying it, but the goaltenders are winning the battle right now.
Here's the Cinderella man, born on the South Shore, Brian Gibbons. BC product, sprints left, cuts in, lost control of the puck, and Hudobin makes the block. Tim Schaller is the seventh Bruin with a chance to win the game in the shootout. The man from the Granite State curls over the blue line. Saved by Schneider.
Well, Schaller's just going to kind of come right down the middle here, a little bit off center. Tries to rip a shot. I know, you keep looking at the Devil's bench waiting for Jimmy Hayes to come out, don't you, Jim?
Here's Severson in the 10th round. He dinks and slams the backhand wide. Hudobin is so active. Must be hard to read him.
Yeah, this is a pretty good move, though, by the defenseman. Pump fake. You just got to have a little bit more patience when you pull it to the backhand. Slow it down, take it an extra 6 inches, and then elevate.
Can the sniper hit the target? East Longmeadow, Massachusetts, is Frank Vetrano. Off the pipe! And the inside of the pipe at that, as the puck bounded behind Schneider and came out the other side.
This is vintage Frank Vetrano. Get to the scoring area and rip a shot. Oh. That's his bread and butter. Clearly beat Schneider. Unlucky for Boston. That's two posts here in the shootout.
Travis Zajac lopes in, and Hudobin stones him.
Well, Jersey's trying a variety of stuff now. We've seen some guys lose some possession. We've seen Deeks. We've seen guys try to go high glove. We saw Boyle try to go high blocker. Now you're trying to see Zajac go five hole, and Hudobin denies him again.
Charlie McAvoy. The 19-year-old cruises in, goes through the legs, and scores! Charlie McAvoy wins it. Anton Khudobin gets his sixth win of the season. He had seven all of last year. And the Bruins have won three in a row.
I mean, this is Khudobin all the way tonight again for Boston. But what a finish by Charlie McAvoy. You know, they say it's a young man's game, and you go across the league, and that's all you see are young players and their fingerprints all over wins and losses. And watch this move. This is a defenseman, Jack. Pump fake, puck off the right hip as if he's going to shoot, and that puck almost threw his legs in by his skates, and then a little bit of flash at the end with a high backhand. And, yeah, act like you've been there before.